All right, bruv, here we go again, back in the video review booth, and this time, the one and only Mark Appleyard in the legendary Sorry.
Woo! Apple butters. Yo, shouts to Rob Carly. I remember in grade 8, he got the VHS and lent me that shit. Whew, I must have watched Appleyard's part in the whole video like 10 times that first night. Never forget this one.
Definitely a fresh download on Kazaa.
Yes.
Definitely made a couple errors the first few times downloading Colin Passy's video part, but you know, after a couple tries, we got there. Well worth the wait. I think we might have a video part that's going to go after Danny Garcia's crown right here, man.
Yeah, man. Appleyard. I'm not really picturing many low scores. Let's see what happens, man. Let's get into it.
All right, where are we starting?
Bruv, probably the easiest of them all, style. Easiest score we've had to give so far, man. It's a 10 all day.
The only question is, like, do you give him 11?
Oh, you trying to fucking...
How do you not give the guy 11?
All right, well, I'm going to stick with my 10.
Yeah, I'm saving my 11 in style for one man and one man only. We got to get him on the pod before we review his video part, though. Next up, Gnar Factor.
Oh, for me, I'm giving him a 9. He's not the gnarliest, but actually, fuck, maybe an 8.5. I'll give him an 8.5 because I'm trying to save those 10s and 9s for the real rail chompers. And he always he loves to 50 a nice big double kink rail in every video part. And that gap to back lip is fucking savage. So I'm going to give him an 8.5.
He also has lots of gnarly nolly tricks too. He's doing gnar tricks every stance. I ain't scared of it, man. I'm giving him a 9 for the gnar factor. He's jumping. He's doing rails. He's doing everything. Flipping into hubbas, you name it.
Yeah, that gap back lip
is good for a 9.
Gap back lip makes me want to give him the 9. But I want to give myself a little wiggle room for, you know, when you're differentiating between fucking a Jamie Foy and like slightly underneath for a 9, you know. I don't know.
Well, luckily for us, we never have to review a Jamie Foy video. Oh. Moving right along over to the tech section. Apple Butters is the perfect mix of tech and gnar.
Yeah.
Mostly gnar though, man. I think he's a little gnarlier than he is tech.
Oh, for sure. That's what we were saying about Hardy. You know what I'm saying? He'll switch up nose grind to big ass rail, but he ain't getting much techer than that. Yeah, for apples.
You're not seeing those tech ledge lines. I think there's only one ledge trick that's just on a ledge on the ground. Is the Nolly 180 switch crooks to start that line. I don't think there's no manuals in this part, right?
Yeah, no, he does. His techish shit is like on rails and hubbas and that little section on the picnic table, flip back nose blunt, nollie flip back 5-0 and shit.
So where are you going for tech?
I gotta give him props for the tech gnar shit, but as far as just tech overall, I hate to do it, but I gotta give apples 6.5.
I gave Hardy 6, and I think they're pretty similar in the tech gnar. Might have to give the slight edge to apples, so I'm gonna have to copy you on that one, man. 6.5.
Word.
I would have went 6 to match Artie, but you know he's got the nollie flip and nollie heel into everything, so slight edge.
Yeah, Hardy's out here slacking, man. Let's not even talk about that fucking bum.
Oh, okay. All right, he ain't slacking on his Instagram live appearances, though. He's out in his front yard every day. Moving right along, the most controversial subject of all our reviews, transition. People want us to be a little harsher than we have been. Not calling ramps to picnic benches transition these days. He did skate the little bump over the rail in Barcelona. Well, that's not much transition
what?
Either.
What, yo, we've
the
been
people
there.
Want us to be harsher, man.
Bro, I think I give that thing a lot of points for
and
transition.
And our toughest critics. That
we went there with.
You're going to give them a lot of points?
We went there with a group of, what were we, 5-6 people that day? And no one.
Yeah, but we're scrubs,
no
man.
One even ollied that shit. That thing is so awkward. And Appleyard was one of the first to bless
that.
Okay,
but back in
thing.
This day, if we had have gone there and no one had have backside flipped it by then, we might be thinking about potentially testing the waters. Nowadays, literally everything's been done over that. You're not going to go there and like ollie it. There's no point, man.
Yeah, shouts to Gustav, nollie big flip. I mean, nollie cab flip.
But the people want us to be harsher. We've been handing out fours and fives on curb cuts, man. I'm going to go with a four.
A four on transition, yeah. So, obviously, Appleyard is a transition god, but he didn't put it on display in this part, right? We can all agree that as a street skater, Appleyard's like as good as it gets on transition. He skates bowls and
everything.
This
isn't a lifetime award.
Yeah.
This is Flip Sorry award.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to give him a fucking... Fuck. Yeah, he didn't go too hard on transition in this part. I'll give him a five, though. Fuck it.
Too hard? He didn't do anything.
I got just mad respect for three flip over that thing. That's no joke, man. To this day.
You better be careful here.
Man, I ain't scared of Cody's fucking opinion.
You gave him a five?
Yeah.
For two tricks over a bump to rail.
He frontside half cab flips into the thing, and nollie frontside flips into the gap to bank and bars too. And nollie front heel,
yeah,
and switch back heel.
He flips over the rail into the bank. All right, five it is. Man, I gave Sinner a five, so who am I to say anything? Bag of tricks. This is his number one spot, man. Every trick he's doing is a choice for every spot. Fuck. I got to give him a 10, man.
Yeah, I got your back on that 10. This part had zero illegal tricks or anything even close to resembling illegal.
It's nothing remotely close.
Yeah, 10.
Moving right along to the kits. Dude, back in the day, we loved his kits. Still, too. This was the greatest Appleyard there was. You were saying earlier you love the era in between this and Really Sorry, which you kind of see as his hair grows a little bit longer in this part. His kits just get better and better.
Yeah, when he's rocking the flannels.
I'm hitting him with a 9.
Yeah, when he's going in on the flannels and his hair is a little longer. Or even the younger stuff with the beanie and the hair popping out. He was just... Everyone wanted to be him. In this stretch from this video to Really Sorry, he was at the top of his game. I believe he got his SOTY around when Really Sorry came out. Unquestioned GOAT. It's a 10 for me as well.
Woo! No, I gave him a 9.
Oh, I'm giving him a 10.
Dude, this score is going to go through the roof. Next up, filming. We're talking about French Fred in his prime. It's about as good as it gets, man, when you match a SOTY like Mark Appleyard with a filmer like French Fred. There's not one bad clip. I've watched this part over and over. One of my favorite clips is the kickback nose grind down that hubba.
Yeah.
The camera starts like completely crooked. I'm going 9 for filming.
9? The only kind of weird clip that I can remember is nollie nose slide that hubba. And then he like his whole like top half of his body's kind of cut off. But yeah, This is just memorable banger after memorable banger, and a big part of that is filming. I'm going to go 10 on the filming, man. It's French Red we're talking about here.
Ooh! Jeez! Moving right along, we're going to edit. We've transformed this category after some confusion in the Sinner review, the edit song confusion. We're just going edit because we believe the song is part of the overall edit. Every skater growing up our age was singing this song for a long, long time after this video part. We would never have listened to it if it wasn't for Apples. And we always loved it just because it was on our CDs. It was on our MP3s. It was on anything you could download it on. You were listening to this song. I'm going 8.
All that for an 8?
Well, that's pretty good.
I mean, that's good, but yo, if I was to not give this part a 10, I would be trying too hard to be a hater. I watched this part thousands of times. He was one of the most influential guys to me. The funny part about the song for me was finally seeing the music video to it a few years later, and it was the most emo fucking makeup fucking weird ass dudes. I'd never seen like what the placebo dudes look like. I remember Tom showed me the music video of his crib once, and I was just cracking up. I'm like, damn, these are the mans I'm listening to on repeat. Back it though.
It blew you away.
Yeah. That's a 10 all day for me.
Man, it was crazy the type of shit we were listening to on our MP3 players while in high school. Having no idea the backstory to half of these fucking bands, huh?
Here skate video tracks.
Next up, overall continuity. You can go first on this one.
Overall continuity, man, it's a 10, man. Like, this part is as close to perfect as there was for me coming up and rewatching it with you today. It's like, it's it still holds up, you know? And style is a huge part of that.
Bringing back those memories.
Yeah, trick selection and style are like two things that are timeless. Unless you're a fan of Fully Flared, maybe that trick selection is not timeless.
No, for crying out loud. Timeless is the best way to put this part, man. I'll back you up. Overall continuity, 10.
Hell yeah.
Last but not least, we're going Ender.
My thing is, like you, I kind of like the nollie flip back 50 a lot better and the suck it. The gap to back lip. There's a few clips that I like better as Ender. I hate to say it, but I just never loved that kick front crooks. The board
bounces off the rail.
Bounces off the rail, and then it's perfect, but I don't know. And then how it goes straight into the kickback 5-0, like, skit, joke, thing, whatever. I'm going to give him 7.5 for Ender.
Can't agree more. When I picture this part, I picture the nollie flip back 50 as the Ender with the suck it. The kick front crooks, obviously mind-blowing. Had the little bounce off the rail, like you said. I would have scored the nollie flip back 50 as a 9.5 Ender.
Yeah.
The kick front crooks, I'm going to have to go with an 8.
Yeah, I'm guessing it was the first one ever on a handrail. I mean, if anyone knows an earlier one, let us know on Instagram. But I'm guessing it was the fact that it was probably an NBD at the time on a handrail. But yeah, I don't know. I just never loved that clip.
All right, you know what time it is. Let's tally up these scores.
Let's get it.
All right, bruv, you got your score?
Got my score, bruv.
I'm going to hold you to it. I think your score is going to be a little bit higher than mine, so I'm going to get mine out of the way, all right?
Let's get it.
This is going to be my second highest score ever, coming in higher than Stevie Williams in the DC video. Surprised myself there. 83.5. Danny Garcia and Mosaic still has the crown for me.
Damn. Not mad at it. Not mad at it. You know what I'm saying? When you're talking about Danny Garcia or Appleyard, probably arguably their best parts they've ever put out. Maybe Appleyard's was really sorry, but that's both goat shit. Can't be mad either way. But yo, he broke the fucking record books for this shit for us so far. I got him at an 87.5.
Holy shit!
As yo, he got 5 10s in a row for me, man. Trick selection, kits, filming, edit, continuity. I forgot about the Ender, too. I figured he would have had a higher score on Ender, but yeah, that kick front crook.
Dude, can you imagine? He might have been close to... He would have been... Would he have been 90 if nollie flip back 50 was Ender?
Yo, he would have been 2.5 more points.
Well, you probably would have scored that at 10.
Yeah, he would have been 90, actually. Goddamn.
Can you imagine he finished the scores with 6 straight 10s to finish with a 90? Holy shit. Mark Appleyard and Sora, you can't watch this goddamn part enough.
French Fred, man, you ruined this 90. You should go back into the archives and re-release this shit. Nollie flip back 50, just so his bunt score that's going to have about 1,000 views on YouTube can be right.